So we have seen how to deploy WebAPI and Angular application on Azure in our previous video. Let's see how to host this application on IIS. We will not only learn the basics in this video, even we will go into depth like how to troubleshoot error in production environments by enabling logs. We will also understand what is an application pool and how pool configuration for .NET Core is different from classic ASP.NET applications. So let's see how to do all these things next. So this is the brand new system. I have installed Windows 10 on this computer so that you can understand how to configure everything from scratch. If IIS is already installed on your system, and if you type IIS here in search box, you will get an option to run IIS in this list. But by default, Windows installation does not enable IIS on your system. If it is not already enabled, you can enable the same by following these steps. Go to Control Panel. Select Install a Program and click this Turn Windows feature on or off. You can see Internet Information Service is not checked. To enable this, click here. You can see instead of a tick mark, a tiny black square appear here. That means by default Windows do not turn all features of IIS. If you expand this preview, you can see FTP server is unticked. That means it is not enabled by default. And in web management tools, only IIS management console is enabled. But we are okay with that. We do not need other features to host our application on IIS. And in the World Wide Web also it enables basic features. And these basic features are sufficient for us. And in performance features, it enables static content compression. Here you can see another option is also available to compress the dynamic content as well. It helps to compress dynamically generated pages, which results in lesser data being sent over the network. The trade-off for enabling this feature is a small increase in CPU at the server for each request, but it will boost the performance of our application if heavy pages are getting generated in our application. But it does not compress XML HTTP request. And our web API will send HTTP XML request only. So there is no benefit to enable this feature for our application. But if you have planned to host a classic ASP.NET type of application, you can enable this feature. I am turning on this feature on this system. And I would like to go with Windows standard for other features. So press OK to enable the features. If now you will search IIS, you can see IIS is here in the list. Click on this to open the IIS manager. By default, IIS is not configured to host ASP.NET Core application. Click on modules. And if you can see ASP.NET Core modules V2 here in the list, you do not have to install anything. But if it is not available in the list, you need to install hosting bundles from Microsoft website. So if it is not enabled, you can go to .NET.microsoft.com/download/.NET-core. Select the .NET version. I am selecting 3.1 as we have used .NET Core 3.1 to create our web API. Download this hosting bundle. It contains .NET Core runtime and IIS support. Run this installer. And it is installed. Let's check if now we get ASP.NET Core module in the list. Yep, it is installed. And now we are ready to host our application on IIS. If we click on this site list, we get this default website. We can browse any of the website listed here by clicking this browse link. Let's add our website by right clicking on this node and select add website from the context menu. Let's name it HSPA. By default, it creates an application pool with the same name of our site. We will understand more about pools later in this video. For now, let's add our application in default app pool. Next, we need to tell what is the physical path of our application directory. we can directly point to the folder where we had published our application in the previous video. But in real life, the internet server is totally on a separate server, and we have FTP access to that folder where our application files are published. So let's create a new folder to replicate the similar kind of scenario. Here in binding section, we need to define the port on which our application should listen. By default, this port is given to the default site hosted for IIS. And if we try to create an application using this default port, we will get a warning. So let's run our application on a different port that is not already in use. So now our site has been added. We just need to publish our application into the new directory we have pointed this site to. One way is we can manually copy the folder where we had published our application in our previous video. We can copy all of these files and paste it into the folder we just have created. In production environment, we usually transfer these files on FTP folder using FileZilla or something else. But as our application folder is on the same system, we can also publish our application using VS Code to a specific directory as well. We can use .NET publish, set configuration to release, and use -o option that we can use to tell our system that what would be the output folder where we would like to publish our application. Let's enter the path of the folder we have set on IIS for our site. So our application is now published. Let's try to browse the application by clicking this browse link. So our application is listening on this port, but it could not start. And if you remember, this is the same error that we got when we published our application on Azure. You must have got the clue where the issue is. And the issue is we have not defined any environment variable yet for our application. That is creating a problem in starting our application. So if you do not have any clue and you want to diagnose that where the issue is and to get the detailed error on this page, we can configure the environment variable to development. Let's see how to add environment variable on IIS. We can configure environment variables from here by clicking this configuration editor. Here from the dropdown, we need to select system.webserver and select ASP.NET Core. And we can add environment variables by clicking this button. Click add link and add the name of environment variable here. Add ASP.NET Core underscore environment and set it to development, as we want to diagnose why our application is not getting started. Close this window and press the apply button. Refresh the page. You can see now we are getting the detailed exception here on this page. And the reason of our application failure is that our application could not get a security key. So similarly, like we just have added ASP.NET Core environment variable, we can add security key as well. And make sure you are using double underscore here. Otherwise, it will not work. Refresh the page. So now we are getting 404 error. That means our application has been started, but because we have not published the Angular application on the www root folder, we are getting this 404 error. Let's try to call our API endpoint to get the list of cities. Perfect. We are getting this list of cities from our local database as we are running this application in a development environment. Let's also deploy our Angular application on IIS so that on the base URL, Angular application can be loaded. At present, there is no www root folder here in our application folder that is hosted on IIS. Let's copy the same from the publish folder that we had created in our previous video on this location. We already have compiled Angular application in this folder. Copy this and paste it here in HSPA IIS folder. So if now we will refresh the page, our Angular application will start to load on this base URL. So this is how we can host Azure and .NET Core Web API on IIS. We have seen how to troubleshoot the issue by setting the environment as development, but it is not always possible. We cannot run application running on production server in development mode just to diagnose the application issue. So how can we diagnose the issue on production server in this case? Let's try to create a scenario to understand it in detail. At present, our API is running in development environment, and in development mode, our application picks database password from appsettings.development.json file. But for production environment, we are getting that password from environment settings. And at present, we have not defined the environment variable for database password yet. So let's assume you are not aware of this problem and you have deployed your application on production server. Let me change it to production to replicate the issue. So if I refresh the page now, I get this error. But suppose this is a real production server where you are not allowed to set the environment to development. How you will troubleshoot your application on IIS in that case? Well, good news is that IIS provides us a feature to enable logs for an application, and we can review the logs to diagnose the application errors later anytime. We can enable loggings on IIS from here. If it is enabled, it will start to create a log file for each and every error with a file name stdout with some date and timestamp in that. Let's enable it and refresh the page. This time in the log folder of our application, we will get this file. If we open this file, you can see this is giving us a complete trace of the error where it is occurring. So currently it is happening in the startup.cs file on line number 39, and error is password value cannot be null. So this is how you can trace the application errors using these error logs. So now we know where the error is, and we can fix our application error by setting a new environment variable called hspa_dbpassword and set its value here. Save it and refresh the page. Ta-da! We got the data from our Azure database, but let me change it back to the development as I do not want to fetch data from Azure database because my free subscription of Azure is going to expire soon and it will start to cost me and I do not want to spend any money for this demo application for now. Now it started to display data from our local database. So IIS has a great UI to configure different settings for .NET Core application. But you would be wondering where these environment settings are saved for an application. So let me tell you, these are stored in web.config file. This file is generated here in the root folder. And if we open this file, you can see all environment variables and settings are stored here. The setting to enable logging is also here. So in case you do not have access to IIS UI, you can put all of these settings and set environment variables in web.config, and you can upload this file on the published folder, and there is no need to configure all these settings through IIS UI. Now the final topic of this video is application pool. Let's understand what a pool is, why a pool is required, and how to configure a pool for .NET Core application. So the application pool allows us to configure a kind of isolation between the different applications running on a single server. If you have been working on .NET application for a long time, you would have remembered the days when a single exception in one application could have caused the failure of all the applications running on the same computer. To solve that problem, application pools came into the picture. It helps us to isolate different applications so that failure of one application does not affect other applications running on the same server. So all the applications hosted on IIS should be put into an application pool. In classic ASP.NET application, everything was hosted inside of IIS worker process, but things are quite different with .NET Core applications. If you remember the flow of .NET Core Web API that we have discussed in the start of this session, we have discussed that .NET Core applications run on its own Kestrel server. So here on IIS, this application pools act just as a proxy to forward request to the Kestrel server. There is no need to have it instantiate a .NET runtime. For .NET Core application, it should be set to use no managed code because all the runtime is managed in the Kestrel. So using .NET CLR for .NET core application is a waste of resources on the server. On the production server, where multiple applications are hosted on the default pool for different frameworks, it is not a good approach to change this to not managed on default pool. Instead, we can create a separate pool here by right-click on this node and add a new application pool here. Let's give it a name HSPA and select no managed code here. Now we can use this pool for our application by going through the advanced setting for a site and set it to HSPA. So hope now you have a good idea on publishing .NET core applications on IIS, and you can easily troubleshoot the problem on production server. So with this video, we have completed our WebAPI session. Next, we will work on completing our Angular application. So at present, we are on Angular 10, and Angular 11 has already been released in November 2020. First, we will migrate our Angular application to Angular 11. Then we will start to implement more features in this application. So see you in the next video. Stay tuned. Bye bye.